Today we will discuss about cnidarian in kingdom Animalia, unit 1, chapter 2, zoology. In the last you have discussed about, that is, we have discussed about the phylum Porifera, and today we are going to discuss about cnidarians. So cnidarians, nido means needle or sting cells in Greek. So cnidarians are previously known as coelenterates, and the cnidarians are the new name. So the cnidarians lives in aquatic, they are aquatic forms with sessile. Sessile means they don't have any attachment to the substratum. They are free swimming. So they are free swimming. They may be solitary, means they may be in single or collineal. Collineal means it groups. And radial symmetry means the body can be divided into two equal halves at any plane. That is called radial symmetry. The name cnidarian is derived from cnidocytes, cnidoblast with stinging cells or nematocysts on the tentacles. Due to the presence of cnidocytes or cnidoblast with stinging cells or nematocysts on the tentacles of cnidarian, the name has arisen as cnidaria. Cnidoblast is used for anchorage, defense, and to capture the prey. So the cnidoblast is used for what? That is, the cnidoblast is the stinging cells. They are used for anchorage, support, defense. If any enemy coming to attack the cnidarians, it is used to attack the enemies. That is the defense, and to capture the prey, to get the food, by capturing the prey. So cnidarians are the first group of animals to exhibit tissue level of organization and or diploblastic. So they are the first to see the tissue level of organization, and diploblastic means it possesses only two layers. That is ectoblastic, that is ectoderm and endoderm. And they have the central vascular cavity where the circulatory and digestive system are in a same path, and they have a single opening called the mouth or the hypostome where the injection and ejection takes place in the same way. So the digestion is both extracellular and intracellular. So they take the food from outside the cell, and inside also the food is taken by the adjacent cells. It takes the food. So intracellular digestion is there, and extracellular digestion is also there. And the nervous system is too primitive. It looks like a thread-like, and it makes a network, net-like structure. So cnidarians like corals. So it looks like a corals due to the deposition of calcium carbonate. And cnidarians have two forms in their body, that is polyp and medusa. So the polyp form is sessile and cylindrical in shape. So the body shape is cylinder. So it is cylindrical in shape, and there is no substratum. That is, they won't attach to any of the substratum. They are free. Example is Hydra and Adamsonia. So you can see this, that is Adamsia. And medusa are umbrella shaped and free swimming. So the cnidarians have both forms in the same organism, and they show the two different generation of life cycle. That is called metagenesis. And the polyp shows the asexual phase, and medusa shows the sexual phase. The polyp gives medusa, that is produces medusa asexually, and the medusa forms polyps sexually. So the development is indirect, and there is a free swimming larval, that is Panula larva is there, and it is free swimming with the help of cilia. And some of the examples are Physalia. This one is Physalia, which is called as Portuguese man of war. They may ask in one mark in your board exam and in your NEET exam. Adamsia, sea anemone. So this one is a sea anemone. Penantula. Penantula is sea pen. It looks like a pen. So this one is penantula, sea pen. Meanderina. Meanderina, brain coral. It looks like the brain shape. So it is a brain coral. Meanderina. So these are the some of the examples of cnidarians. Hope you understand the topic. If you like the topic, give a like, share and subscribe to Science Easy Tech channel.